George Collins walked out one May morning when May was all in bloom. And there he espied a fair pretty maid, washing her white marble stone. She wooed, she hollered, she hired her voice, and waved her lily white hand. "Come hither to me, George Collins," cried she, "for your life shall not last you long." He put his foot on the broad water side, and over the river sprang he. He embraced her around her middle so small, and kissed her red rosy cheeks. George Collins rode home to his father's own house and knocked at the ring. "Arise, arise, dear father," he cried, "arise and let me in." "Arise, arise, dear mother," he cried, "arise and shake up my bed." "Arise, arise, dear sister," he cried, "get a napkin to tie round my head. And if I should chance to die this night, as I suppose I shall, you bury me under that white marble stone that lays in fair Eleanor's hall." Fair Eleanor sat in her room so fine, working her silken skein, and she saw the fairest corpse a-coming that ever the sun shone on. Fair Eleanor said unto her head maid, "Whose corpse is this so fine?" "It is George Collins's corpse a-coming that once was a true lover of thine." "Oh, come, put him down, my six pretty lads, and open his coffin so fine that I might kiss his lily white lips, for 10,000 times he has kissed mine. You go upstairs and fetch me the sheet that's wove with the silver twine, and hang that over George Collins's head. Tomorrow it shall hang over mine." This news was carried to London town, and wrote on London gate. There were six pretty maids died in one night, and all for George Collins's sake.